Gina Dowd, adolescent psychotherapist. Gina, we had another very interesting session with a group of parents last week, where once again there were lots of insightful observations and questions that are occupying parents' minds during COVID-19.
There are, Liam. And I think since this series started, what we found is that when the parents are in discussion with each other, they're actually answering many of these questions themselves. But like anybody at the moment, without the resources that we normally have to parent, we focus in on what behaviors are causing us concern. We wonder again, are we getting it right? And I think parents are doing very well in posing a number of questions and asking to take part in a discussion about their adolescent and really about their care and compassion for their adolescent, because they're all striving to understand this process that we describe as adolescent development, and they're trying to support and understand the adolescent as they present with various challenges, with various wonders, and to try and get it right.
Okay, so questions that came up. First one, I'm finding it really difficult to help my 18-year-old regulate. Any tips?
Often when we think of that word regulate, we automatically come up with that term dysregulated. So in some way, the behavior isn't what we call normal, or maybe it's not acceptable, or maybe it's trying to see what is this adolescent trying to convey to themselves or to the parent. Think about 18 years of age. Apparently, it's when we officially become adults. But I think, as most of us know, 18 years old is really only that stage of going into leaving cert, maybe leaving school and finding an apprenticeship. So it's often that trying to decide which direction the compass should go in. So to have a regulated 18-year-old, I would think, would be amazing. To have an 18-year-old who is displaying a range of behaviors is what I would call the norm. Now, obviously, I don't know the background to this adolescent and if this is new behavior or if it's something that has become a concern over time. What's this 18-year-old up to? What stage are they at, is what I would be asking. What's the norm for them? How do they normally communicate within the family, with peers, even with themselves? And I would be asking this parent, is the behavior hugely different, or is it in line with how this adolescent has been developing? So when the parent says they want them to regulate, I guess what I'm going to guess from that is that there's been some arguments, there's been some concerns, and the parent is at one end of the spectrum and the adolescent is at the other. So if we're going to support the adolescent and understand them, find out what they're looking for. Often they don't know. Give them some options, usually two or three is enough, and find out what's maybe worrying them and concern them. They don't always confide in parents, but they usually do give an indication of what is a struggle for them. And if you can find out subtly a few of those things, then you begin to help them navigate where they want to go. A lot of adolescents are coming up recently and making contact with me saying, I'm thinking of repeating fifth year, I'm not sure what to do. And what I'm actually asking them to do is hold off until they get back to school, because there's going to be a lot of guidance, there's going to be a lot of support from teachers. They will all have interacted with each other before the school year starts. So step back first and take a little bit of guidance from the professionals in this area where education is their priority. Then you may have a choice to make. And maybe that, you know, these are things an adolescent is already thinking about, but we never make good decisions at a time of panic. So when this parent thinks of regulation, maybe they need to ask themselves, what's my expectation of my adolescent? How do I want them to be in the world, whether that's behavior-wise, showing up-wise, and where do I need to steer them towards? And if this parent can stay within their value system, and I always talk about this, their norms, they're going to guide their adolescent. Doesn't mean they're going to be on the same journey or the same path, but they are going to influence them. And it's trusting sometimes the end point in that journey that we can't always see. but that you are navigating with them on this journey of its ups and downs.
Okay, very good. How do you support a 16-year-old with behavioral challenges?
I'd say to this parent, what's their 16-year-old like? How do they ask for help? How do they withdraw? How do they let you know when they're happy or maybe when they're stressed? So revisit your 16-year-old before lockdown, before pandemic. What are they normally like? And then ask yourself, is there something out of the ordinary here at the moment that I have become aware of or that I feel I need to do something with now? I think it's wonderful that this parent has said, how do you support a 16-year-old? So it isn't how do you control them? How do you, you know, put manners on them? I think there's a lovely statement there. So if this parent is interested in support, I would say to this parent, how would you like to support your 16-year-old? And which issue of behavior is it you would like to support them with? Is it their upset? Is it their tears? Is it their defenses? What's showing up here? And I think I have mentioned this a few times in the talk. We all come with two sides to our personality. And often you're trying to direct your energies away from the behavior, not trying to fix the behavior, but appeal to that adolescent that you often get glimpses of. Appeal to that gentle, that warm, that gorgeous side that makes that adolescent amazing to you. And you may only get a fraction of it, but that's the part where you check in and you say, I wonder what is happening for you at the minute. I have noticed that there seems to be something of upset in your life, or it's using your own language and your own words. But often we're just tapping in and we're saying, I'm giving you full permission to vent, to rage, to be tearful, to be whatever. And I will help you figure it out. So I think this parent is already on a good road here with their question, because the parent seems to acknowledge there's behavioral challenges, but that support is the way forward. And sometimes, I ask a parent, think back to their 16-year-old self. What would they have needed when they were 16? What were the challenges? Yes, we're in a different world, but sometimes adolescent development, doesn't alter that much. Our outside world changes, but that internal world of the adolescent is as full of crises, in the 80s and 90s as they are now, because it's all related to development and who I am. So maybe check in, what was happening for me when I was 16? What would I have needed? And translate that across into the support that this parent is clearly saying and is clearly on a really good road.
Very good. The final question that carries over from the event, Gina, is motivating a 14-year-old or motivation of a 14-year-old, where to start?
Where to start? Well, I would start with the 14-year-old as opposed to the word motivation, because I think by now anybody that has listened to me knows that the myth of motivation, I suppose, is something I talk about and I steer away from. And I would look at this 14-year-old. Okay, what year are they in? What developmentally, where are they at? Are they a 14-year-old? Are they, in fact, maybe a 12-year-old? So then I would gauge the support to the 14-year-old of how they present in the world. Is this a 14-year-old who's very directional, knows what they want? Is this a 14-year-old that has suddenly become unmotivated, is staying in bed, and is saying, I can't be bothered. What's the point? So a lot of parents are having to have conversations with adolescents that they don't have an answer to at the minute, because none of us know what the landscape is going to look like. I mean, if we only look to what the government has advised, it's a stage process. And adolescence is a stage process. It has its highs, it has its lows, it has its pauses and its stop points. But I would again ask this parent, what do they want to support this actual adolescent with? Are they concerned, like many parents are at the minute, that they're staying in bed a little bit longer, that they're not applying themselves to the books, that everything is a little bit temperamental? again, we have to expect those behavioural challenges and changes at the minute. Certainly, you know, we see them in ourselves as adults, our good day and our not so good day at the moment. And it's to expect some of that with a 14-year-old. So where to start? Start from their own gut instinct. What's their sense of what's happening? Be like that private detective and get curious with your 14-year-old. And often that's a trial and error of trying to find out what is happening for them, be it in their mind and be it in their body. Adolescent development hasn't stalled. Just because our world has gone to a slower pace, it doesn't mean that we're not constantly in a state of anxiety, panic, worry about the future, worry about a date, worry about the shape of the body, the shape of the mind. All of that is still happening. It's just happening in a smaller space at the minute, and they're not in a position to bounce off their friends, where some of that was absorbed or in school. So get curious, be the detective. What's your 14-year-old normally like? Do you actually have a concern, or is it around the routine? Is it around the structures? Prioritize what you think is needed. Maybe it's nutrition you focus on today to help the mood. Maybe it's getting a healthier sleep habit and not flipping that day for night. So step back. The fact that you've asked the question always already suggests to me this parent has knowledge and has understanding. And often a lot of my work is about supporting parents with the skills and competencies they have. And it's like a check-in process when I do parental work. You know, you've got this. Now, if you're asking the question, you've already got the answer, but maybe you don't like the answer you're coming up with. So check out what the concern is, you know, look for evidence, and then present it to the 14-year-old. If that doesn't work, we try a different route. But sometimes a parent also needs to just step back and let the anxiety, you know, let it land where it is, let the concern land, and then check in at later on in the day. I'm wondering, is there something I can help with here? So the fact that all these parents are asking, first of all, highlights that they're interested. Second of all, highlights they're involved in their adolescent's life. And thirdly, it shows that they have a curiosity to try and get this right, which of itself is wonderful. And if you want to use the word motivation, there's motivation of itself. But more importantly, there's support.
Okay, very good, Gina. Just to go through your other elements of your slide, and people can learn more about these in our previous videos in this series as well, and indeed probably future ones too, on the Planet Youth page here on YouTube. You've touched on that already: motivation versus understanding, routine versus structure, challenge versus support, understanding your adolescent. That language infects everything you say. It's about seeing things a little bit differently. As you said, you picked up there the word support as opposed to control or punish or reprimand or something like that. So
yeah,
there's a lot of selflessness needed in being a parent, isn't there?
There is. You know, sometimes we can get problem saturated, and I think a parent's biggest concern is my adolescent going to make it? And research shows us, yes, they do. You know, by age 30, most of them have made it by one way or another. And I'm not underestimating the concerns that parents have or the challenges that do sometimes happen where, you know, adolescents end up in various situations. But it's about the parent prioritizing. It's about them understanding their own parental style and understanding what their adolescent, you know, is presenting with. And, you know, sometimes it's as simple as that word think, because we all have thoughts about ourselves. And then we have thoughts about our adolescents. So is the particular thought I'm having about my adolescent, is it helpful or is it problem saturated? Is it inspiring? Am I looking at that critical side of them or the developing side? Is this thought necessary right now? Is it really a specific concern right now? And am I being kind to myself and to my adolescent? And when I say that, am I doing a good enough job as a parent? Am I seeing this adolescent for the developing being that they are with all their highs and lows? And it's really sometimes just using that word think, because when we actually think, we manage our expectations much differently. I often parents want more for their adolescent and they want life to be easier. But does that actually fit in with where the adolescent is at? Because a lot of parenting is tried in with hopes and dreams, and we need to have them. But then it's having the courage to sometimes step back and to say, okay, this is my dream. This is where I want my adolescent to go. Is this where they're able to go? And can I acknowledge that? Can I just step back and say, okay, let's meet in the middle here, or, you know, I'm going to take a step back, or this is about love, or this is about, you know, something else. Because we all know we're all influenced by our own upbringing, by maybe some things parents missed out on, by some things that weren't easier. But the adolescent hasn't lived that journey. Sometimes it's ours to own, and it's ours to have the courage to change our mindset. But all of the parents, certainly, and I think you'd agree, Liam, that we have met through the course of all these webinars, they have been interested, they have been creative, they have been open, and they have been honest. That's what adolescent development needs. Not perfection, not amazing, good enough.
Okay, well, thank you very much, Gina. That's the latest, as we said, in our series of feedbacks from our workshops run by Planet Youth, Parenting Your Teenager During COVID-19. And as I said, you can check more of them out here on the Planet Youth YouTube page. Thank you very much, Gina, for joining us this afternoon and giving the benefit of your insight once again.
Thank you, Liam.